Number 7 midfielder, Nick Reyes. Number 14 forward,
Tyron Hutchings.
And number 11 forward, Vito Paletto.
Substitutes for Lane United.
Number 5 forward, Christian Catalunya. Number 6 defender, Casey Phillips. Number 7 defender, Christian De Luis. Number 8 midfielder, Richie Hurtado. Number 2 defender, Luke Connolly. Number 12 midfielder, Matias Binder. And number 17 midfielder, Isma Fernández.
Starters for Calgary.
And now starters for the Calgary FC. Number 31 goalkeeper, Sean Melvin. Number 2 defender, Dean Northover. Number 3 defender, Massimo Megna.
Number 5,
Jonathan Whelan, defender. Number 15, defender, Jean-Pierre Rodriguez Luis. Number 20, midfielder, Miguel Romeo. Number 8, midfielder, Elijah Akube. Number 4, midfielder, Mitch Boche. Number 9, forward, Dominic Russo. Number 17, forward, Darius Ramsay. And number 19, forward, Brad Camden. The coach for Calgary is Tommy Wilden Jr. He is assisted by Brendan O'Connell and Leon Hapgood. And now the starting lineup for Lane United FC. Number 1 goalkeeper, Matthew Bersano. Number 3 defender, Christian Couteau. Number 13 defender, Brendan Anderson. Number 21 defender, Jonathan Stadler. Number 11 defender, Amir Sasaverovich. Number 31 defender and midfielder, Will Seymour. Number 9, midfielder, Orlando Velasquez. Number 24, midfielder, Alex Pantoja. Number 16, midfielder, Daly Stevens. Number 29, midfielder, Dion Jones. And number 14, forward, Timothy Mueller. Lane United FC is coached by John Gallus. He is assisted by Connor Cavaletti. The center referee for tonight's match is Andrew Brooks. He's assisted by Andrew Marahart and Bennett Savage. The fourth official is William Baldwin. And now please stand and face the flags as recording artist Emily Jensen performs both the Canadian and American national anthems.
Through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watched were so gallantly streaming, and the rockets' red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled banner yet wave o'er the land of the free and the home of the
Oh, that's nice. There you go. And it is sanctioned, as we found.
Are we good? No. Are we live?
As in live now.
Alrighty, well, we have gotten O Canada out of the way. We do have a Canadian team in-house tonight. We've gotten our own national anthem out of the way. The Red Aces are in mid-season form, yes. And unfortunately we cannot so much say the same so far for Lane United, that you hate to start off on that note, but it's been the talking point of the season so far, 0-4-1 through the start of league play. What has to change?
Well, it's definitely a process. I know we've talked about the cohesiveness of the group. They do have a number of games underneath them now. But I think that the focus from John Gallus and training would be still finding a starting lineup that creates the most opportunities on goal. And obviously a starting lineup that puts most balls in the back of the net.
Yeah, and on that note of the starting lineup, a couple of different faces in the starting 11 for Lane United today. We'll see Rolando Velasquez make his first start. We did see him play pretty well a couple times at this point, particularly in that exhibition game. And then also Deion Jones getting the start in place of the suspended Jordan Jones. And there were some cards to talk about from Lane United's road trip. At one point, they were down both keepers, and they had to throw Brendan Anderson into goal after Chris Lowermore was sent off in a game where Matthew Bersano, who will get the start today, was already serving a suspension. So kind of that's the way the road trip went for Lane United. They did start off the last game they played right after the last home game. They were able to get a point out of in a very entertaining 3-3 draw. Unfortunately for them, they just couldn't hold on and get those extra 2 points. So we'll have to see what they can do today. It is the first meeting between Lane United and Calgary Foothills FC. Calgary, a new team in the PDL, but very established and organized youth club in the city of Calgary. And they draw from that youth club, as a lot of these PDL teams do, for their starting 11. And then some other imports and college products as well. But with that, we're underway. So we'll get going here. A touch for Will Seymour. Plays it up the middle.
Keep an eye on number 9, Rolando Velasquez, here on the right. He is very good in 1v1 situations. If they can get him the ball, I think you can expect good things as far as going forward for Lane United.
Not headed out of play. Lane United throwing and just inside the Calgary half.
Already, Lane United showing more numbers in the attack than they have in previous weeks. They maybe have been given the green light to push a little higher, take a little more space from the opponent, and hope to possess a little bit longer up there.
Yeah, I think you look to change things up when you get in a situation like Lane United is in. So we'll watch for that as Calgary tries to move forward from the back. A long pass immediately and taken by Lane United, and a foul drawn there. Going down on the play was Brendan Anderson. And a little bit slow to get up, but easily up on his own power eventually and just playing it back to Bersano.
Also, keep an eye on the Lane United midfield. They are the link between success and not having success, in my opinion. I think if they can get more touches on the ball, if they can find the space in front of their back line and find some space around their the opponent's midfield, they could definitely play a huge part in getting the 3 points today.
Yeah, Lane trying to get it up there to Mueller, a little bit not able to win the ball there. And we'll see them try to find Mueller in one-on-one situations as well. Near side touch here for Calgary's Massimo Menya. And then cuts into the middle, Mitchell Bosch. Now Elijah Adekugbe. Back for Menya to the middle. And the opposite, number three, Christian Kuto.
When Lane United play out today, keep an eye on Will Seymour, number 31. He is a key player in producing attacks forward. A lot of the play goes through him. Now, if he can get a more positive ball into the higher midfielders or into a striker or winger, once again, you'll see more opportunities for Lane United.
Meanwhile here, though, the opportunity is still with Calgary and going down in the box there a little bit too easily for the referee's liking. Was a Calgary player.
Mueller will be on his own up front today in a 4-1-4-1. A lot of the direct play might go to him, so from a back, maybe bypass the midfield and go over the top to him. Although I do think John wants to see more opportunities produced on the ground and through build-up play.
Yeah, and we'll have to watch. You know, Lane likes to make those kind of high numbers of short passes, but we'll see if maybe Seymour can just combine directly with Mueller. From kind of that holding midfielder position.
Absolutely. That would be a nice addition to their attack.
And played there for Bradley Camden. Camden chips it to the middle, and that was immediately deflected out for a corner. So dangerous right off the bat from Calgary.
Very dangerous. And here we are again in a set piece, the corner kick that in the previous games we've seen Lane United have a hard time with a clearance, sometimes have a hard time with the communication piece, resulting in very close.
So there comes the corner, kind of low into the box, chested, and Anderson trying to carefully play this one. And now Will Seymour. Seymour with a move to Mueller. Here's dangerous with Velasquez on the wing, but couldn't get it up to him.
Rolando was in great position there on the left to get that through ball. Mueller wins it back. Good work.
Well done indeed, and we'll have to watch that combination of Mueller and Velasquez. Kind of, you like having the big and a little up top, and I think the two of them fit that description.
Yeah, I think Mueller will attract, you know, a couple of defenders. Velasquez is there for the 1v1 on the outside right here. If they can get him in, he's an exciting player, explosive, extremely attack-minded, and does a good job usually beating the first line of pressure.
Free kick restart off the offside and moving up the pitch now. Dean Northover tried to get it to the middle and Brendan Anderson clears. It's going to be back to Northover. He'll throw in.
Could be a physically challenging game too. Calgary look like they have some bigger bodies on the field, not meaning that they get an advantage there, but it does take a toll in challenges, aerial challenges, and sometimes in 1v1 challenges.
Headed there, but back to Menya. Seymour falls down there and gets it to Deion Jones. Jones recognizable on the field with that hair.
Pantoja came across on that one. They had him on a 1v0 there in the middle of the field, but they missed.
Here's Mueller with numbers in support, but it was taken away from him. If they really hurried, they might have had a 3-on-2 break there. Touch for Sasaverovic, back to Mueller. And now on the far wing there. Back to the middle for Calgary, Menya in support and they'll get it to him. Trying to dance around but immediately knocked away there and now back from Velasquez and right back to him. Velasquez will try and size up Massimo Meña.
And for Calgary, Darius Ramsay there on the outside as a sort of an outside right winger just already showed us that he has some speed to his game and can do it with and without the ball. So definitely something to keep an eye on when Calgary attack.
Well, Elijah Adukugbe there, a little dangerous in the middle, and ball bouncing around everywhere. Eventually, it's going to be a restart for Lane United. Seymour picks himself back up. Very slow-going restart, but not much excitement off of a free kick in that position. Though plenty of excitement to be had at this PDL level.
Good already. The wingers from Lane United checking into space, something we haven't seen much of in the last few games. We've normally seen them running away from the ball, but this time they are finding the seams that they are creating, and that the midfield have a clear path to play through to a forward, which is a good thing for hold-up attacks and just the number one, keep possession with the ball, but obviously with a purpose of going forward.
Well, now going forward with it in the midfield is FC Calgary, and that long ball just played too long and to no one in particular. Bersano collects, and now he'll pick it up and put it down. You can stay up to date with what's happening throughout the league at uslpdl.com. You can also become a fan of the PDL on Facebook. Visit facebook.com/uslpdl for exclusive league news and interactive content. Down to the other end now, and the opposite keeper between the sticks today is Sean Melvin, all the way at the bottom of our roster.
Melvin, a big keeper, but one that likes to play out with his feet, which makes me happy as a viewer, as a soccer viewer, and also an enthusiast of smaller soccer, so much of the direct stuff.
There's a shot from a long way out there from Calgary, and it went over the bar, but not sure what it is about the way the air swirls in front of that goal in particular here, but I feel like we've seen some funny stuff happen in the net that Matthew Bersano is currently defending.
Velasquez here in a 1v1 if they give him the ball.
And they tried to, but a little bit in front of Daly Stevens, and he couldn't make the connection happen. Taken away now, trying to cut through the middle there was Bradley Camden, and he's going to get a yellow card for his struggles on the play after taking down a Lane United player. And it was Daly Stevens, who is not the largest man on the pitch. So the yellow card, according to the scoreboard in the 10th minute, our score clock did start a little bit late, so maybe the referee's book will have it in the 11th.
Now we want to keep an eye here for Stevens and Pantoja to find this ball through the middle of the field, see if we can some link-up play. Instead, we went to Mueller on a direct ball. That is a tough ball for a forward to receive. It's head height with pressure on your back. It's very hard to take down and do anything with it.
We talk sometimes about the only time you've really got the advantage as the attacking player in this sport is on that first touch, and when that first touch comes with your head, a very challenging thing.
Indeed.
Far side wing is Calgary now. And they chip it to the middle. They get it there in the shot, up and over. Deflected out for a corner kick, Calgary, their second of the game. So they'll try and swing it in again. This one a little bit higher up, looking for the heads, but knocked away by Sasaverovic. This time just a throw-in for Calgary. Much warmer today than the last time we were up on top of this storage container. Warm enough you think you really got to start thinking about it as a player?
It's sort of towards the end of the big heat, I guess you could call it. There's a nice breeze. I think the players will be fine.
And Mueller there trying to win that one and create something, was able to knock it out off of a Calgary player, so it's a Lane United throw-in, and Pantoja tried to connect with Daly Stevens.
That was good stuff. Pantoja and Stevens on the same side while Seymour sat in the middle for the switch if they needed to switch the point of attack through him.
Jones.
Already good shape by the midfield to try to sort of create that link play.
And now back to Bersano and to his calm hands. He'll put it down.
Velasquez again on the seam. Oof. So center backs could take a little more risk and try playing him that ball in front of him.
Yeah, Velasquez is kind of testing that back line, trying to time the run just right.
Well, Velasquez receives there. He's created space behind him, which Mueller would love to occupy. But the ball needs to be delivered there first to Velasquez's feet.
And they'll try to do exactly that, but headed away by Calgary and playing a little bit of pinball here as it goes head-to-head. Velasquez will chase down and then try and defend a little physically and swing and a miss on the tackle, but still draws a whistle. At the back now, moving forward with it, Jean-Pierre Rodriguez Lemos. Not enough to have two names. And again, far side of the field for Calgary, back. Just got to go with his initials there. He'll be JPRL. It's a lot to try and say even when you give just the first letters. Headed there, they were trying to find Menya. Cleared away by Anderson. Massimo Menya will throw in.
So Lane United set in a 4-1-4-1 defensive block. They did a good job of holding low pressure and then staying organized. I saw good communication, but keep your eye on that shape and how consistent they are with it. If they are, they will make Calgary's life very hard to find space down the middle of the field.
Well, cutting to the middle of the box there was Mitchell Bosch, but eventually just deflected out of play for a throw-in, and now they'll trade turnovers here. Throw-in coming for the Reds, Christian Coto. He's trying to get guys moving up the pitch. Gets it for Pantoja, but deflected right back to Calgary.
And again, back into the 4-1-4-1, low pressure. See if we can congest the middle of the field, force play wide. And there you go.
Far side there, trying to get around the defense. Throw in right in front of the corner flag for Calgary. About 15 minutes elapsed in this one, still no score. And now the throw in Lane United's way. Trying to get it to Mueller here. He'll try to make the throw in, but the referee disagreed with possession. And in fact, the foul call is the throw-in coming here, or the free kick, rather. And just back in defense for Jonathan Wielden. Velasquez through the legs of a Calgary player there.
Daly Stevens in some great space. They can connect with Mueller.
And Mueller does get the ball back, and Velasquez now last touched by Velasquez, thrown in immediately by Menya. And collision there.
Good.
Lane United with the ball and some options here.
A quick counter. He has a run on the left.
Deion Jones will go for that runner on the left. They try to get the ball to the middle there, but has to just be cleared away. Danger not over yet, though.
No, that was a good
corner.
A good
coming for Lane United. Very positive there.
Good counter. Winning the ball in the middle of the field and immediately getting numbers ahead of the ball, which resulted in not close to an opportunity on goal, but ultimately a corner kick.
Well, Velasquez will go take the corner, and he's got some big bodies to aim for. Daly Stevens standing right next to the Calgary keeper does not make himself look taller standing next to him. I'm familiar with the struggle, Daly. Very familiar. Throw in now for Lane United after the corner. Velasquez will take again. And Sasaverovic has it deflected. So lather, rinse, repeat, another throw in here.
Yeah, I'm just thinking about that last counterattack. Calgary sort of starting to look a little slower, and they're reacting more than anticipating. And Sasaverovic's pace there could cause problems here in the future on other counterattacks that are created by Lane United's defending.
Well, the whistle there goes against Lane United, so a throw in for Calgary, and they'll get a chance to just throw everyone up the pitch here before they take it and get set up themselves. Comes in there and it's going to go back to the back line for Calgary. Still trying to push up the pitch here as FC Calgary. And now Daly Stevens will win that one.
Dominic Russo for Calgary doing a good job coming back in the four to defeat the 4-1-4-1 and get himself the ball higher up the field.
Pantoja trying to find Mueller, but coming way out, almost out of the box. And I think he was in there, but some arguments from some in the stands. When are they not going to be, though?
Even more impressive, the run Mueller made. It was a diagonal run as opposed to just a direct up and down north and south run, and that will cause havoc on center backs all day. So keep an eye on that as well. Mueller's sort of become a little bit more creative thinking this time around.
Yeah, and that's what we need to see from Mueller and what we know he can do. He's scored plenty of goals for Oregon State combining with Jordan Jones. And now
again, he has
back
an opportunity here for a diagonal.
So Lane trying to get a little bit set up rather than just breaking at speed. Velasquez couldn't find Pantoja, but it's okay because Calgary couldn't find Dominic Russo. All the way back for Sean Melvin. 19th minute of play on the board. And moving with the ball there. And it's Jonathan Wheeldon knocking it way up the pitch, and Bersano is just going to come and catch it. Little bit of an advantage when you can be the only one to use your hands.
Yeah, Lane United trying to get Will Seymour a little bit more involved with play. He has influenced the game that many times with the ball at his feet. Defensively, he's doing a good job, but they definitely want to play through him. He has good ideas, and he's
Pantoja trying to find Mueller there, and a little bit too far, but certainly the last 6 minutes or so, we've seen some good stuff out of the boys in red.
Definitely.
Calgary now taking their time here. And they do play, they play like a team very well, this Calgary unit, because of the way that they're sort of organized and coming up through that youth system. They've spent more time playing together than a lot of their counterparts in the PDL, and I think that's been part of the struggle for Lane United. It's just that they didn't become a cohesive group until, you know, half a week before the season.
Here's
Pantoja there for Mueller. Mueller with the chance. Mueller with the keeper. He gets around him. Oh, off the post, though. And he can't believe it.
Great work by Pantoja to take that space. He was waiting for Mueller to get ahead of his defender. Played a great ball, outlet ball to the left with perfect pace, perfect weight on it. And it was just up to Mueller to put it in the back of the net. He tried to beat the keeper off a good cut to the inside, but cut it a little bit too far, eliminating his angle to put it between the sticks.
But not the first chance we've seen for Lane United tonight, probably the best one, but they've been good, and the challenge is just kind of turning good into great.
Yeah, those are definitely ones you have to put away to get yourself some confidence, to break the ice a little bit with your season.
Well, over hit ball there once more, too far out in front of Massimo Menya. It's a fun name to say. And Pantoja trying to shield it from Menya. All the way back.
Oh, Calgary keeper, their back's extremely high because of the low pressure. If they were to experience a little bit more pressure on immediate pressure on the ball, you'll see those backs come back and support the player in possession. But no need to do that right now when there's such low pressure.
Daly Stevens nearly starting a counterattack there, but very temporary one. And then Will Seymour has to just come in and knock it out of play. A counterattack seems to be an effective weapon so far for John Gallus today.
Yeah, looking good. And I'm more impressed that the midfielders have had the patience to wait for their help to arrive and then reward them with some good in through and back balls, sometimes just through balls.
And another corner coming. This time it'll be from the far side corner rather than the near side corner. Miguel Romo trots over to take it. Or Romeo. Dropping syllables here. And corner kick comes in, headed by Mueller. And Velasquez tries to take it away, but still with it and doing a great job of controlling it was Elijah Ajukugbe, and then he ran directly into a much larger man. A discussion between the two teams there. I don't know what Calgary expects Mueller to have done there. Kind of just the case of being the bigger dude. But the free kick does come for Calgary. Another good time to remind you about some of the sponsors that work so hard to bring you these Lane United games. Of course, you are watching on YouTube. YouTube is the official league online home offering live games like this one and feature content. Subscribe for free to the PDL YouTube channel today. You can also follow at USL PDL on Twitter to become a PDL League insider, join club conversations, and track notable alumni throughout their pro careers.
This looks a little long, but it's a setup pass.
They play for the setup. It does take an odd deflection, and another one has to be chased out, but a throw in Lane United. Velasquez will drop it back. Nike is a proud sponsor of the PDL. Follow at Nike Soccer on Twitter for all the latest Nike Soccer information.
So right here, Lane United have committed almost all their midfield, a winger and a striker, to one ball, which eliminates the ability to switch to the other side. So keeping or hoping that Seymour sort of floats more to the central part of the field, allowing Stevens and Pantoja to do all the work ahead of him and support that ball on the outside. But no reason to commit too many numbers to one side of the field.
Well, a free kick coming about 10 yards south of the midfield stripe. Knocked up the pitch there. And now just sort of cleared up. Going back to collect it now, and off a paw there.
Velasquez is having a hard time connecting with his teammates, receiving the ball well, but his final ideas resulted in quite a number of turnovers so far.
Well, he tried to get around some guys himself there, showed some impressive footwork, but ultimately Calgary gets the ball back. Headed up the pitch now, and again from head to head. Calgary moves it forward, and Brendan Anderson comes through, makes a physical play there, and much to the chagrin of the referees, both in red on the field and in the stands, the foul goes against Lane United. Another great turnout here at the Willamalane Center. We've seen great fan support all season. And a lot of folks enjoying the Oakshire served here. Lane United would like to thank its official jersey, beer, and broadcast sponsor, Oakshire Brewing of Eugene. Ooh. And now, this is dangerous here. Pantoja just sort of playing it in the middle. Gets it from Mueller. Another dangerous one from Mueller. This time, no mistake. It's taken quite a long time. But Lane United have found the back of the net at home in PDL play. What just happened? Tell us all about it.
Very interesting ball played in through to Mueller that he played back in the air to Pantoja, who put it over the top of a defender. got on the other side, did a good job advancing up the field and playing a great through ball to Mueller, who had complimented him with a great finish.
And red smoke emerging from the Red Aces as Timothy Mueller nets it. 1-0 Lane United, and boy, does that feel good to say.
So far, pretty obvious that Pantoja is their go-to, Lane United's go-to guy when it comes to creative ideas in the midfield. Keep, you know, hoping that he gets the ball as much as possible, finds those spaces, because when he does have the time and space to make execute an idea, good things follow.
Well, Calgary now turning up the power and up the volume, trying to respond. And now they'll move back a little bit here. Fans came alive a little bit after that goal. May not be able to hear much of it on the broadcast. We're just not mic'd that way, but a noticeable difference. And now Deion Jones on the far side.
Seymour getting ahead of the ball. Ooh.
And now back to the midfield. And still in the midfield. Good move there from Bradley Camden. Lane United able to take away, though. Rolando Velasquez tried to play it off a back heel there, but there was no one behind him, so Calgary with it.
Wieldon and Rodriguez are having a hard time with Mueller's diagonal runs. He's not just receiving the ball, but he's making him to open up space in the middle, which Lane United have done a decent job filling and making life hard up there for the center backs to sort of get themselves out of a tight situation, creating 2v2s, sometimes 3v2s. It's not an easy life for a center back that continues to experience that.
And now Seymour and Daly Stevens just kind of playing catch a little bit. And now going down but picking himself back up was Mueller, but the foul for the original trip there.
As Mueller drifts right, which he's been doing most of this half, I'd love to see Rolando get in to the space that Mueller has left him in the central part of the field, high up the field, because he will find himself in a 1v1, but this time down the middle of the field as opposed to on the outside.
Sasa Varvich will get the restart for Lane United. AR, if you haven't caught on yet, Lane United in the red and white, Calgary in the black and white. Maybe mention that a little earlier next time as
it was a great
the
ball
shot
in by
off
Sasa
the head of Mueller.
Great ball in.
Very, very, very good indeed.
Nice driven ball. Easy for a tall forward to get his head on and redirect it into the goal.
I'd like to thank both of these teams for having legible jersey numbers after our experience last
time. Definitely helps. Thank you, Calgary.
Very, very nice. Very polite of the Canadians, as is known to be. In the midfield there, trying to find the winger there, and it's 3-on-3 crime. Headed in, dangerous one somewhere. Bersano with the save, but not enough of one.
So Calgary has extreme patience when they play out of the back. They have great discipline in their spacing. I was just noticing Megna here on the left, who created that goal. Plays high up, was in plenty of space, and then the long diagonal ended up landing on his foot. That is something Lane United want to keep an eye on, and obviously the root of the problem would be eliminating the big long ball, but when it does happen, maybe creating a 2v1 with Lane United to mark Megna here and eliminate his chance of that service.
And the goal scorer getting on the end of that was Darius Ramsay, and Persano was able to get a lot of it, but ended up in the inside of the side netting behind the goal line. 1-1 the score. Daly Stevens.
It's Koto Deion on Jones. The right. Koto with tons of space, and he has a Pantoja ahead of him that would, as we all know now, can do good things with the ball.
Instead, he finds Velasquez. Now back to Daly Stevens, rather. And Mueller to the wing. Sasavarovic gets around a man. He'll try to get it into the middle for Deion Jones, but instead a corner kick. Lane United. Velasquez is going to trot down there to take it and maybe pick up the corner flag while he's at it.
And encouraging Sasaverovic to go forward, just looking at his ball control and his pace. It's something, a halftime point maybe for John Gallus to address the team with, because
Corner floated, headed, and has to be headed again. But out for a goal kick before it was headed by Lane United.
Just a reminder, fans, Oakshire Brewing Wine Dry Rye IPA, Reclamation Lager, and Expressive Stout are all now pouring at the beer garden.
It's that long diagonal. So they're picking on Cueto here on the left side of the field for us. They see something they like. They like that matchup.
And we'd also like to take this moment to remind you today's broadcast is brought to you in part by KMTR News Source 16 in Eugene. KMTR is Lane United FC's official media partner. And trying to move up the pitch again, Lane United.
Calgary showing a little bit more high pressure, eliminating the short ball for Bersano and looking to make him play a little longer. He finds a winger on the left there that sort of alleviates the pressure for now. But as you can see, Calgary sticking to their guns and staying with medium to high pressure.
And Cueto in a little bit of space on the near side wing here. Ball there. Mueller plays it, and now Mueller trying to get around, but couldn't keep track of the football.
No, but fantastic job by Mueller coming back into the mix to get the ball and create something different than an over-the-top look. That was something that needs to continue to happen, not just today, but for the rest of the season, for Lane United to see more opportunities and, you know, hopefully more results.
And still trying to work something here is Lane United. Good move by Velasquez to keep possession. Moving up the pitch now are the Reds. They'll try to get it to Mueller. Mueller has Gian Jones behind him, but instead went to keep it to the middle.
I like the Mueller-Pantoja relationship. They seem to play off each other well. Continue to look at them in the attack when either one have the ball.
That's a yellow card challenge there. And Daly Stevens, I don't think that was acting. And indeed, we are going to see the trainer come out and have a talk with him. Just right in the back heel there, he just got caught. 34th minute for the booking.
So Lane will look to serve this ball into the box. I'm going to guess they're going to be looking for Mueller's head here, so keep an eye on Mueller's movement. Hopefully it's a diagonal run in front of the 6-yard box for a tap and goal with his head. Also look for a teammate of his to work off that long ball and wait for the ball to come down to their feet and finish a rebound goal.
Yeah, we've seen that a couple times against Lane United this year.
Yes, we have.
It's not always the play directly off of the set piece, but directly after it sometimes that can be the most dangerous one.
Yeah.
You can think of a South Sound goal or two, or a Timbers goal scored that way up at Providence Park off the corner kick, and first sort of defensive play was made by Lane United, but then it fell right to a Timbers foot.
You see players sometimes take their mind off after the initial play has happened and give up those type of opportunities, and can be natural for that to happen to a player late in a half or a game, for that mental breakdown to occur.
Well, it's Pantoja and Dion Jones that are behind the ball.
Just having two in the box, Mueller and Velasquez are given the job
instead
to put it in.
Played wide there. Now they go to the box, and
there's their second ball.
Does get to one time shot, and
it's a great hit.
That was may have found its way onto a goal of the year list or two.
Sure.
The quick restart after it, though, and now the whistle comes back.
Smart by Pantoja. He didn't commit into the box. He waited for that ball to shoot out to him and almost found himself celebrating.
Would not have been the only one celebrating that goal. I think we'd have a few happy Reds here. Kembo with it. Camden, rather. Now again, Daly Stevens, who seems to be doing better after taking that knock. Dion Jones for Cueto.
Velasquez has now moved to the left side.
And see Will Seymour with the head.
They can get him in a 1v1 where he can now cut inside and get the shot rather than across.
Dangerous for Calgary here, becoming increasingly so. Gets that to Camden, who was had a lower corner there to shoot at, but ended up going off a Lane United foot for a corner kick.
So I'm looking at the clock, and I'm thinking if I'm Lane United, I need to learn from my mistakes and not give up a big momentum goal here before the end of the half.
The momentum can be so important in sports, and sometimes even more so at a little bit lower levels.
Just a poor ball in, but he'll get another shot at it.
And another cross that is more dangerous. It is headed, and it is saved. Well done, Matthew Bersano on the save. And throws it up the pitch there. Will Seymour now. Seymour's got Deion Jones in some space. Plays it back, though.
Now, if Deion can go inside here and find that gap behind Pantoja, that is a key pass. That space that Pantoja just took is going to
well,
be critical.
There is Pantoja and possession. Another booking here. And that is number five, Jonathan Wilden being naughty. And once again, the magic spray coming out. And very hospitable here at Willamalane Center. They have now just decided to put Calgary's goal on the board. If you weren't paying attention, it was actually scored. It was scored, about several moments ago. We'll go with that. 29th minute's what I have written down. Took a minute to read the handwriting. Not always easy with my chicken scratch. So you were talking about Lane United keeping that momentum, maybe doing one more positive thing between now and the end of the first half. We've talked about, you know, a couple ways to make that happen. You know, what's the one thing that's most essential for Lane United rest of the half?
Keep finding those midfielders in the space between the forward or the back line of Calgary and then their midfield line. There's plenty of space for Lane United players to occupy. It's just going to take a little bit more awareness and some vision. Already we've seen Pantoja keep his eyes up and has exploited that space. Daly Stevens on the other end has done a good job sort of switching in and out, yet they haven't found his feet enough. I think getting those forwards to come back too will switch things up, make play a lot less predictable by Lane United.
Well, temporarily playing with 10 are the Reds as Pantoja's on the sideline waiting to be welcomed back into the game. Velasquez will take the free kick and it has to be collected by the keeper, Sean Melvin, and Pantoja let back onto the pitch, 11-11 in the 40th minute. 1-1 the score in Eugene. Or Springfield, are we? Which?
Springfield, yes.
Which side of the border are we on here? Sasaverovic slides in there, knocks it out of play. Throw in coming. And Calgary here still trying to set something up. Ball played in. They were looking to try and get Massimo Menio with possession. Back to Weldon.
The Sasaverovic-Ramsay matchup is a great one for the public here to keep an eye on. They are two speedy players, two very competitive players. Both like to get the ball at their feet and go one at one another. So that could produce some good matchups here in the closing minutes.
And back to Menio again. Chested down. Trying to get around Cotto.
His hands are on him. Oh, no call.
No whistle there. Loose in the box. Still trying to dance around there was Bradley Camden, but taken away by Lane United, and now a free kick for Lane United deep inside their own half.
So we'll see which team wants to go for it and take a little more risk to finish out the half. I imagine they both will play it cool. Sit back a little bit defensively, won't press too much.
Bersano will put his foot through this one here. tries to get it directly to Deion Jones. It's over his head. Jones, though, can track it down if he's fast enough, and he is.
Jones in a 1v2. He should give this ball up. There you go.
He gets it to the middle, and Daly Stevens now. Stevens with it off a chest and a throw in coming. Still the Reds' ball. Good work by Stevens there to keep the pedal down for Lane United. Not bad work from Deion Jones to chase that one either.
No, that was even better that he recognized that he was in at a disadvantage with the numbers being one versus two, and played a good ball off across the box.
That one comes in,
it's
and
deep, it's still in.
Was a little dangerous there as the ball sort of disappeared at the feet in the box. Now Will Seymour with it. Koto in a lot of space.
There's something we want to see too. Lane United getting their outside backs higher up the field, so they not only provide another attacking body, but also provide an option when the middle of the field's too congested. And right there, Koto playing high, recognizing the pressure, doesn't need to come back and support. Gets us another player into the middle third, almost the attacking third.
Daly Stevens involved in another collision there, and is a tough dude, number 16 in red. Gets thrown around a lot, but always right back up on his feet.
Outside back here. Manya, yeah, he's open again, so be careful. This is what burned him last time.
And the first time shot there goes wanting.
Yeah, it looks like Stevens might be in need of some more medical attention.
Could some
that
repairs.
Right,
yeah. Might be one of those cases of sort of re-aggravating something. He did took the knock earlier where he had the tackle come in directly onto that ankle, I think is going to bother him every time he takes any kind of a hit the rest of the night.
Definitely. Looked like two of the same type of tackles that resulted in the same type of injury. So hopefully he'll be okay. But it looks like the switch will officially be made. Stevens off.
So Daly Stevens does leave, and with the injury problems Lane United have had, you can certainly not put a lot of blame on that bench for taking things conservatively. One of the big names that is not there tonight for Lane United, hasn't been there for a while for Lane United, is the showman from last year, Valdo V. And he can make a lot of things happen shooting, he can make a lot of things happen passing. Just a very quality number 10 for Lane United. Not in the options for John Gallus tonight.
No, but good to see Pantoja, filling that role and being the creative midfielder, and has done a great job linking up with Mueller. See if we can get more of that in the second half.
Brendan Anderson with it there.
Velasquez having a really hard time connecting. Every time he receives, he's had an extremely hard time picking up his head and playing the most simple ball to start off. As a player, you want to sort of break the ice with your confidence by playing the most simple ball, and then eventually go on to bigger and more creative things.
Well, we are approaching stoppage time here. And welcome to stoppage time. So no subs board in Eugene, so anybody's guess how much stoppage time, but could be
Mueller in a 1v1.
Could be a little bit with the way this half is gone. Here is Mueller. Mueller trying to get
into the
play.
He has a runner. And there
tries to get Fernandez, the shot! And goes wide, but boy, we talked about momentum. That would have been a little bit going into the half.
That would have been a great goal. A great goal because Mueller recognized that he had a runner coming in behind, played a great angled ball back. The finish was just wide.
So it will be Isma Fernandez then who replaces Daly Stevens. Keep an eye out for big number 17 the rest of the way. Brendan Anderson wins possession there. Gets it to Jones. Jones now to Velasquez, who tries to get around and goes down, no foul, Calgary ball. Far side wing. FC Calgary trying to get some momentum of their own at the end of the half here as Pantoja plays it to Will Seymour. Taken away again by Calgary. Middle of the park for Miguel Romeo. And now back to the center backs.
See Calgary being a little hesitant, not finding the middle of the field. They have a couple checking midfielders that, just like that, that want the ball yet have not been rewarded with a through pass.
And another long shot there that just looked like it may have ended up dipping, but in the end, no danger. Goal kick coming for Bersano, and it may end up proving to be the last kick of the half.
For Calgary to get back into this, they need to establish more of a midfield presence, allowing Ramsay on the outside to take advantage of those 1v1 situations in all that space.
And indeed, it is the last kick of the half. That'll do it for us for 45 minutes of play. Much better
much
for
Lane
United
much
so
better,
far.
Much better,
I think. The time away from home, the games themselves might not have gone so well, but I think now to be back after that, things seem to be starting to come together a little bit as a team and sort of capitalizing off of each other's strengths and a great goal that we've seen so far. So hopefully more of the same in the second half. We'll take a quick break and reset, and you don't go anywhere. Just about ready for the second half, and what are you looking to see? Big changes for Lane United or more of the same?
No, I think John will keep most of his lineup out there, but for success to continue, Mueller and Pantoja need to continue to find that space in between the lines of Calgary's midfield and defensive line. And then find the positive touch, not the negative touch, and the attacking touch. It was what was lacking in previous games, and it's good to see today, and it's already produced double the opportunities of what's happened in the earlier parts of the season.
Isma Fernández came in.
Well, immediately the ball up on the Lane United defensive half of the field. We did have a change at halftime. Casey Phillips comes on for Amir Sasavarovich, and if you missed it right before the end of the first half, Isma Fernández came on for the injured Daly Stevens. One more reminder as well, Lane United would like to thank its official jersey, beer, and broadcast sponsor, Oakshire Brewing of Eugene. And we'd like to take this moment to remind you that today's broadcast is brought to you in part by KMTR News Source 16 in Eugene. KMTR is Lane United's official media partner. So with the formalities out of the way, we're back for the second half here. There is a touch for Phillips' head. And again, running into some bodies here in the middle, trying to find the diagonal run there was Mitchell Bosch. Will Seymour with a touch, and Docito's around his man, but can't control it. Moving up the pitch for Bosch again. Bosch, and it's deflected, but comes down and trying to take it on the fall there was Miguel Romeo.
So Lane United have opted to play longer out of the back today, eliminating Seymour's involvement. He used to be a little bit more involved. Now here's an opportunity for us to see whether or not Seymour receives in the space next to the striker from Calgary.
Well, so far through this first minute or so, the closest thing to the chances that we've seen have come for FC Calgary, but lots of football left in this one. And just keeping it in on the near side there is Darius Ramsay. Ramsay lost it though, and now Velasquez has it. Velasquez couldn't quite snipe that one through on the pass. And still trying to make something happen there. Doing a lot himself was Bradley Camden. Brendan Anderson up to Deion Jones. We've seen Jones float a couple different positions around the pitch. And Cotto back to Bersano. Casey Phillips standing alone in a lot of space right in front of us. Instead, they tried to find Mueller and it was too much.
So a focus for Lane United to sort of try to perform today would be to get more than one midfielder involved in the attack. And you, as we all saw, Pantoja did immense work in between the lines getting the ball forward. So and now he has the help of Isma and he has the help of Seymour. But if neither one of those guys can step in, Pantoja is going to get pretty tired of doing the same of all the work and will need someone to complement his work right there.
Well, dangerous moments there for Calgary. It all started with Daly Stevens, Casey Phillips rather, making a great read defensively, but ball bounced around a little bit and ended up on a counterattack for Calgary, and Darius Ramsay nearly was able to combine with Dominic Russo and put the ball in the back of the net, but you don't get any goals for nearly.
Calgary
touch for Seymour.
With some good organized pressing here, or medium pressure, I'll say. But they're doing a very good job of anticipating Lane United's next option playing out of the back and have forced them to play long just like that.
And they did play long, and then it was headed all the way back and now ends up going out for another goal kick. So we'll see if Bersano plays this one short or long. We've seen him do both.
Yeah. Dominic Russo, sort of the ringleader in the pressing department. He's vocally organizing the team and physically, you know, giving good advice. He's showing with his hand where he wants his next defender. So if that stays consistent, it'll be a hard time. It'll make it a hard time for Lane United getting out of the back.
And here is Will Seymour in the middle of the field, taken away by Calgary, and Mueller eventually able to dribble that one, but not before the foul called. Free kick coming just behind the midfield stripe. And going backwards with it was Dominic Zator, who is subbed onto this game at some point. If we can identify who left, we'll let you know. Left to do a lot of guesswork up here. And United playing defense to defense and then clearing forward. Anderson's going to chase that one, and we'll watch it go out of play for a goal kick. 50th minute. Score is still 1-1. Lane United took the 1-0 lead and then gave it up about 5 minutes later. Good play from Mueller there to Jones. Jones to Pantoja and Fernandez. Fernandez now to the box. He shoots, but wide. Boy, we've called Isma Fernandez's name a few times since he's come on. Watch for that the rest of the night.
Isma doing the right thing, going low and far post. Unfortunate not to get that inside the post.
Starting to see the Spanish Armada come together, though. It's good to see. Throw in coming, and I'll get to the right spot and now take it.
So by Calgary pushing higher up when Lane United play out, just like we're about to experience, they eliminate the ability for Lane United's outside backs, which are Koto and Phillips, to get higher up the field because they have to give immediate support. So by doing that, they make Lane United play through the middle where the seams are wide open for Rolando Velasquez, for Mueller, and for Dion over there to find. Now it's crucial for them to recognize that and exploit that space. Otherwise, the outside backs will not be an option.
A touch now for the center back, Jonathan Stadler. And now back to him. Started the game today, did Stadler. Haven't gotten a chance to call his name too many times, but that's maybe not a bad thing when you're not mentioning a center back by name. Pantoja with a touch there, does get it to Mueller. And Mueller will play a long ball there. Good job to get it out to the wing. And now back to Dion Jones. Jones to Isma. Isma turned and went down, apparently not fouled. And Casey Phillips will knock that one up and out of play to the first row. Plenty of fans, plenty of kids here. Very, very nice place to take the family. Parents can enjoy some Oakshire. Kids can invade the field at halftime. Truly something for everybody.
It's a tough spot for Mueller. He's in a 1v4. Mathematically, shouldn't win that ball.
Not the greatest odds, 1v4, but if there's anyone who can do it, it may be Mueller. And now Will Seymour pressing high up here. Seymour still with the ball and sort of a stop, and now he'll restart.
Waiting for more support. If he gets it, this could be something.
And he plays it to Jones. They tried to find Mueller, but it was taken away by Calgary. They still have it in the Lane United attacking half. And now Lane will just sort of stroll back and allow Calgary to set something up.
Yeah, Calgary definitely not opting to counterattack there. They would much rather play out like they've been doing the entire game. Like I said before, their spacing is very disciplined. The one thing they're lacking, though, is that attacking mentality of wanting to go forward and exploit numbers up situations.
Velasquez tried to knock that one forward, but it was intercepted itself. Far wing now.
Lane United with a great number of players committed to this ball here. The situation should be resolved.
And Anderson will
get in a good position there, but realizes he doesn't have to make a play and allows it to roll out.
Lane staying very disciplined in their 4-1, 4-1. It seems to be helping them, the players, more visually. There's more cues in a 4-1, 4-1 to where you can sort of feel more confident in your decisions when you get into a defensive block. In a 4-3, sometimes there's a little bit too much room for imagination, but here it's very very obvious to anyone on the field what needs to happen next. Looks like they've had a week or so preparing with it, so good to see that it's effective.
Dangerous chance for Calgary. Doesn't lead to a shot from Dominic Russo, but sometimes you're just trying to get into attacking position and sustain. Some kids in front of us enjoying some ice cream folded into a waffle. What will they think of next?
Oof. Good opportunity for a counterattack if they decide to go. Lane United.
Trying to play it to the referee there.
On the right side, wide open in a 1v0.
And they will get it to him. Now he plays it back to Seymour. And Seymour will go back to Anderson. Slid in there and winning the ball, but also getting a whistle for his troubles.
So once that long switch happens, we've seen it already a few times in this game, once a long switch of play happens, a long diagonal ball to the other side resulting in a 1v1 or a 1v0, the next pass through should be on a diagonal run. So if a forward or a midfielder decides to make a diagonal run across the field to support the player, that is a critical pass in getting yourself and finding yourself in a very good position to score a goal. So keep an eye on the long diagonal by Mueller, maybe by Rolando Velasquez, once that long diagonal switch occurs.
Well, on that tackle, a yellow card going against Lane United. Persanjo goes out to just pick that one out of the air.
Going with the 1v3, that's a tough ball for Rolando. I don't think that's something John wants to see much of today.
I think it could have been worse, though, as it had to be knocked out of play by Calgary, so the Lane United throw-in. Deion Jones to Velasquez. Velasquez will try and just charge up on goal here. And losing track of the football, taken away from him. Camden tries to knock it up, but it goes out of play, and a touch for John Gallus.
Still has it.
Out of play again, throw in this time. Going the opposite way for the visitors in white. 57th minute of play, so we're nearing the hour mark, almost two-thirds of the way through this one. And the throw-in again for Calgary. Stuck in the middle of the park at the moment is the ball, and just throwing Will Seymour to the ground, which is not entirely legal in this game of soccer, was Dominic Russo. So free kick and a restart for Lane United.
So Pantoja coming near. See if Seymour can go a little higher now that Pantoja has taken his space. Looks like Seymour's going to stay put. Again, Pantoja nearest to the ball. It's important for Lane United to recognize that he is one of the attacking mids. So to fill his space in higher up the field would be ideal, so you don't lose a man in the attack.
And throw in again. And you might be familiar with this. Throw in again for Calgary here as Rolando Velasquez has taken a seat. Restart the game just the same, and Velasquez does appear to be in a little bit of discomfort. You see him take a knock at all, or are you thinking maybe just something muscle related?
I didn't see what had happened, but he looks like he's in quite a bit of pain. Good thing we have the best trainer around for this type of stuff, Cesar Ocampo.
Always an important part of the team. And he will come and tend to Velasquez as Calgary sets up a free kick of their own. We'll wait until we can get equal numbers on the field. So you don't really want to speculate what it is that Velasquez is dealing with. One more time, we'd like to thank Oakshire Brewing of Eugene. Lane United would like to thank its official jersey, beer, and broadcast sponsor, Oakshire Brewing of Eugene. I'd also like to take this moment to remind you that today's broadcast is brought to you in part by KMTR News Source 16 in Eugene. KMTR is Lane United's official media partner.
Looks like Kata's coming on for Rolando Velasquez.
And so indeed it will be Kata or Christian Catalunya for number 9, Rolando Velasquez. So the second man to leave due to injury tonight. Both of them were able to walk off under their own power, but John Gallus opting to err on the safe side and bring in replacements or reinforcements. You may have heard the official announced attendance. We'll take a break there, as that was almost a goal for Calgary, but 505 people, the announced attendance, which is a good number here. I think it's the first time we've been north of 500 this season. Good to see the team growing in Eugene.
And Springfield.
And in Springfield, where we are actually located for this game, the Willamalane Center.
All of Lane County.
I think that 505 might include the parents watching the kids' baseball game right next door, but they can see, they can hear, and it was actually kind of cool to watch that game, or the warm-ups of that game completely stopped during the national anthem, and everyone just turned. Always cool to see what a simple song can do that. Meanwhile, now Koto on the sideline shields that one and will take a throw-in. We've passed the one-hour mark now. And Isma Fernández with the ball has two Calgary players around him and is able to temporarily sustain possession and was actually able to get the ball out off of one of them as Lane United will get the throw. Right at the midfield stripe, the throw-in comes. And they try to find Mueller, but he can't control. Chance for Calgary and Pantoja. Nice move by Pantoja to just roll the ball back, get a little bit of space, and now knock it to the back line, and now for Casey Phillips. Phillips has Catalunya on the wing, but didn't go for him. Now he does. And now it's too much on it.
Right idea. Phillips went inside with his touch, releasing some space for Kata to use, but just overhit the pass a little bit. I see that as a nice little weapon here for the second half. Phillips comfortable on the ball. Kata just came in, has a fresh set of legs. We can see more taking the inside space and playing Kata wide and getting some more services from the outside. That would definitely make the attack a little bit more or less predictable.
Well, now it's going to be Calgary moving up the pitch here after a brief touch of possession for Lane United. Calgary still trying to be very, very organized and very sort of particular about the way that they attack.
They're keeping their backs extremely high, now trying to break this pressure in the middle of the field. It's a long diagonal to the opposite side. I think they have the players to do it, and I think they can be very dangerous if the ball lands on one of those.
Well, it does land and was chested down there, but might have been a call against Calgary, and free kick coming for Lane United. Minute. Trainer coming out now to attend to a Calgary player. And Dirk Vanderveld comes on to replace Couteau.
Fans, Nike is the proud sponsor of the PDL. Follow at Nike Soccer on Twitter for all the latest Nike Soccer information. You can also follow at USL PDL on Twitter. Twitter to become a PDL League insider. Join club conversations and track notable alumni through their pro careers.
64th minute here. What have we seen the same? What have we seen different in the second half?
Well, the pace has slowed down a little bit. Both teams experiencing sort of their second wind, hopefully here in the next couple of minutes. But I've seen Calgary go back into their same attack, which is, you know, a disciplined, well-spaced, organized attack, yet a little slow sometimes. For them to get a goal, they need to continue to push forward and get those positive ideas executed on the field as opposed to just continue to go negative. Lane United, I think, they're starting to get some of their backs, their outside backs here, Phillips, into the attack. I'd love to see both sides use more and giving Mueller and Pantoja a little bit of a break. I think Isma's been a great addition to this half, too. He's definitely brought some good energy.
Yeah, Isma's been kind of a firecracker since he came on and has had a couple of different chances that if they'd found the back of the net, we would be discussing at the end of the season. But as we've said, unfortunately, you don't get anything for almost. Still 1-1 as Bersano puts his foot through that one and it goes up and out of play for a Calgary throw. Sun's starting to disappear behind the industrial factory type, whatever exactly it is, behind the Willamalane Center. It's the descriptive powers of a broadcaster there.
We got Phillips on a nice run on the outside here.
Oh, Pantoja does just catch up to that, but couldn't direct it, and now it's Pantoja who's down in a little bit of discomfort. Really good job there by the Calgary player. Was on the ground, but able to just turn and chest it to himself. And now it does roll out of play for another goal kick.
Fantastic work. He makes the save on his chest to keep it in, or keep himself on the ball, and then spins and makes a great through ball. Had it been a little slower, might have resulted in a shot on goal.
And Poletto is a substitute for Calgary. He does replace Darius Ramsay. And Calgary still trying to sort of pick here and get something going, but that was too far out in front of the winger, and it'll be a throw in for Lane United. Vanderveld to take it in the 67th minute of play. 1-1 still the score. Lane United seeking their first win of the PDL season, their first point at home. They did have a 3-1 comeback win in an exhibition game to start the year, but as far as PDL play goes, they've not been as lucky so far.
Lane United all committed to one side of the ball, or one side of the field. See if some options open up on the opposite side, which is right now just Phillips.
Well, now they do move it to that opposite side, but it is Casey Phillips a little bit lonely, so he has to knock it to Will Seymour. Seymour tried to part the Red Seas there, but couldn't keep possession while he did.
Caught that a little upset there. He had a great attacking run in behind the backs, but Seymour did not release.
And Kata again will escape here, and now it's an opportunity. Christian Catalunya.
Good inside cut.
Catalunya trying to find Mueller, but couldn't connect. But
he was being nice there. I thought he'd take one more touch and maybe have a shot on goal, but you know, Mueller making an interesting diagonal run up front could have resulted in something too. But I don't blame him for taking that, playing that pass instead.
And that did excite the fans a little bit. Haven't had as much to stand up about in the second half as far as attacking chances as they did in the latter part of the first, but still solid play from Lane United. Hope maintaining this 1-1 draw for now, holding on to a point. But you'd like three. Bersano has to come out to pick that one. He does. And now Mueller trying to settle that one down and knock it up to himself. Mueller still trying to get to it. Mueller in front, but the whistle had gone. And
considering the mathematical disadvantage in being one versus three, Mueller has done an outstanding job of actually getting the ball, keeping the ball, and almost creating something all by himself. impressive stuff.
He's an impressive player to watch, and sometimes all the more impressive when he does have his teammate, his college teammate, Jordan Jones. Meanwhile, here's dangerous for Calgary, and we've talked about this already more than once this time, sometime this year rather. Sometimes, as Dominic Russo saw there, it can be that much harder when you have that much more space. Not a lot of time there, but not a great angle either, but not a lot of people around him.
No, but keep paying attention to Russo and his diagonal runs. They are short bursts. He times it very well. He makes a short diagonal in front of the line, and that's not the only one. He's done it throughout the game, but he is a dangerous player just in a little bit of space. Keep an eye on his ability to sort of manipulate what's happening with the center backs and then exploit the space that he's creating for himself with a short diagonal.
And Pantoja trying to set something up there as the pace of the game starting to accelerate a little bit as we inch toward the final 20 minutes. Another whistle. This will go Lane United's direction. The drumming from the Red Aces has continued. And a discussion with the referee here.
Stadler getting up now, which makes sense. So Lane United leaving one in front, one in back of Russo, just to make sure this doesn't turn into a counterattack where Russo's in a 1v1, and then committing numbers forward to see if they can get on the end of this.
Well, they get that to the box, but it's headed away by Calgary right back to the taker of the free kick, and now all the way back to Matthew Bersano.
It's important the outside backs stay high here so they have a quick outlet to the outside, and we keep the advantage, the spatial advantage.
Catalunya trying to hit that one forward with the side of his foot.
That's a foul.
That a foul indeed there.
It's a good tactical foul. Slowing down the forward progress. Not the worst thing he could have done.
Here's Russo again. Russo trying to maintain some physical presence of his own and trying to get a little too fancy with that cross was Dean Northover, and it goes up out of play, goal kick.
YouTube is the league's official online video home, offering live games and feature content. Subscribe for free to the PDL YouTube channel today.
And Matthias Binder entering for Lane United. See who, in fact, he's the replacement for. We'll let you know as soon as we know. Phillips heads it there and
second ball. Get ahead of the ball, Kata. No. Get ahead of the ball, Kata. There he is.
Catalunya has it taken away and
gets
the foul and will, in fact, get booked. He wants an explanation. And he'll get one along with his yellow card. I don't know if he was satisfied with the explanation, but I think a foul indeed.
Yeah, he got himself into trouble there. He held the ball a little too long, which made the pressure get there a little bit, come to a little bit too fast, we'll say, and he sort of went into survival mode by getting himself in a tough tackle.
Substitution for Lane United FC coming in for Deion Jones is number 12, Matthias.
But I like what he's doing on the ball. Kata's attack-minded player has continued over and over to find the space in behind this right back here and potentially could get himself.
Oh, here's Russo. Russo in some space, dancing around in the box, gets the shot off, a second shot, and hits some legs one time and shoots it right at Bersano the second.
Russo is definitely Calgary's response to Mueller.
Yeah, a lot of lot to contend with those two up front. If you didn't hear the official announcement of that Binder substitution, he did come on for Deion Jones. Long ball there. They try to find Russo, and now Russo flips it for Mitchell Bosch. Bosch still with it. And curling shot from Bosch, and that one may or may not have been going out, but Bersano not about to risk it and is able to just get both hands on it firmly and control it, and now we'll put the boot through it.
Considering how effective Russo's been in the second half, Seymour has to do a better job of communicating with his center backs and picking him up or shielding his passing lane so they don't have a clear look to play Russo's feet.
And Man United trying to get Matthias Binder and his fresh legs involved. All the way out wide to Casey Phillips, who tried to find the head of Mueller. He couldn't, but it does end up with Binder. And now Binder gets it in, and the kind of shot cross combo there will just be collected easily by Sean Melvin.
See, like right now, Russo has a clear lane. We need to slide someone over in front to cut off that clear lane. Congesting the middle, pushing Calgary to push or play balls wide as opposed to just down the middle of the field. He is an excellent player to have in that position. Already he's proven himself capable of solving this game on his own. So a little bit more attention his way by Seymour. Seymour's a little too high for me right now, allowing that to happen. There he goes.
Well, here they go again to the far wing, and or near wing, rather. Hit in by Northover off the foot of Phillips. Corner coming. Big focus for the last 15 minutes of this game from you.
15 minutes of, if you're the home team, I think you're going for your 3 points and reward this crowd, but reward your team and break that ice and get that win. So you want to push numbers forward as much as possible, sort of bring up the energy, take advantage of all set pieces. If I'm Calgary, considering how my season's gone, go for it for a little bit more, for a little while longer, and then maybe they settle on a tie.
Well, here's Binder now, freshest guy on the field, and he'll lay the pass there. And now back to the midfield.
Pantoja has found himself on the outsides now. In the first half, he was more on the inside. Now he's on the outside. He has yet to see much of the ball, and he's yet to influence the game as much as he did in the first half. That could also be tired legs.
Casey Phillips had a little bit of a triangle there set up between himself, Pantoja, and Kata, but instead played back.
Exactly. If they do get it here, they do have a numbers up situation to where they have the tools to exploit that space.
There is Cataluña. He's onside. Keeper comes way out, has to play it with his chest, but eventually just knocking it towards touch, but actually kept in by Sean Melvin.
Last call for beer at the beer garden.
And then Bosch tries to play it, and they announce last call for the beer garden, and we see so far just one member of the Red Aces running from their far side of the field towards the Oakshire tent. It's a big deal when they announce last call.
It's the second most important thing happening right now.
And some substitutions for Calgary, and I'm sure John Gallus doesn't mind the fact that he sees Dominic Russo leaving. Also leaving the pitch is Miguel Romeo, although the counter to that, I suppose, is now you've got Russo's replacement with entirely fresh legs and 13 minutes to work with. But as dangerous as we've seen Dominic be, I don't think Lane United minds to see him go.
It was good movement, though, by Pantoja to create the space for Kata to get into. And
Fernandez to Binder, who's playing a little more centrally than we've seen him play so far. And Kata tried to play it back to the middle, but knocked away by Calgary.
I think the Spanish players on this team are a little shaken by the physicality that the PDL offers. It's the fouls are a little bit more harsh. The use of the body is a little bit more common. So getting used to that, I think, is critical for this team to have success.
Oh, that's an awkward bounce. And I think there were some nervous folks here when the whistle blew and the collision in that part of the field. The referee didn't immediately point Lane United's way, and he held the drama to the last possible second before giving Matthew Bersano the free kick. Lane United have had some penalty drama this year, and that was a big part of the road trip. We talked about at one point Brendan Anderson having to put the gloves on after Chris Lowermore was sent off when Matthew Bersano was serving a suspension. So not a good sequence of events a couple of games ago, but no deja vu right now.
Sounds like a PDL road game.
A little bit like it, a little bit indeed. Played back, and Calgary now deliberate, organized, holding on to the ball. Lane United equally organized in defense, or trying to be, and Kata takes that one away. Now they get it to Kata again. He plays it to the middle of the field, but taken away by Calgary. And now here it does come, FC Calgary. They get it to the box. Oh, great back heel. I don't think the pass there was entirely necessary, but
no.
It was sure pretty.
Could have turned and had a shot on goal, but didn't know that he didn't have pressure behind him.
Nothing on the end of it, and then that one too far out in front of Mueller.
So if Lane United continue to defend, organize in that block, I don't see Calgary being able to penetrate that block. But if they do get stretched out and get beat on a counterattack, that could result in a goal, and the other way would be a poor choice or a bad pass in the middle of the field that could also result in a goal.
And the subs that came on just a moment ago for Calgary are Nick Reyes and Tyron Hutchings, as the Red Aces, who did obtain their last call beer, are welcomed back to applause from their fellow Red Aces. I'm sure there may have been more than one brought back.
There, Pantoja now floating to the middle of the field. Creates some space, but Mueller in a 1v, oh, 2v3.
Oh, this is dangerous for Mueller. Mueller tries to get to that, and
again, though, so great job creating something out of nothing. And that's just from, you know, the timing of the jump to having the attacking mentality, and obviously staying on his feet helps too. But that was an excellent job by him.
And here, chance for FC Calgary again into the last 10 minutes of play. They play that cross wide, gets it off the chest, but too strong. And while we still have a moment here, I would like to, after thanking all the sponsors, like to thank everyone that has helped directly on air with the broadcast. Of course, my color commentator, as always, Gabriel Hernandez, our producer, Dylan Lee, cameraman, Josh Carter, and our trusty producer, Dylan Lee. And I think I may have thanked him twice there, but not to forget the media coordinator. Dylan does indeed, and the media coordinator is Chris Burke. Bersano having to get a little creative with his footwork there. Ends up getting the ball out eventually. Will Seymour. And now back to Seymour, back to Phillips. And Pantoja. Pantoja right at the defense. And the physical play, it's not even the fouls that are physical in the PDL so much as it just everything off the ball. A lot of collisions, a lot of large bodies, and it takes a toll on you. Our next broadcast will be Wednesday, June 10th, a non-league game against the Vancouver Victory. Casey Phillips will watch that one go back to Bersano, who will catch it and then just rolls it to Stadler. 83rd minute here. And Binder back. Pantoja knocks it down, collects it, and tries to get it to Catalunya, but headed away. Calgary now, a little bit more urgency in their own game. Here's Bosch trying to move into a lot of space himself. Bosch has done lot of running.
Number 14, Hutchings, has been an exciting player to watch for Calgary ever since he came on. And he's definitely, you can tell in his body language that he wants to end this game in a 2-1 victory, with him being the goal scorer for Calgary. So keeping an eye on him from, you know, Seymour just being a little bit more careful with or aware of Hutchings' movement. And then obviously our center backs need to do equally as good of a job. Keep an eye on him.
Well, if we're going to see anybody get that second goal to make it 2-1, we're going to see it in the next 6.5 minutes or so. Lane United knocked down there. They didn't like it, but no call. Calgary now, opportunity. Shot comes through, and a save by Matthew Bersano. Boy, was that dangerous. Very from Vito close. Paletto.
Very close. Great save.
And the corner coming. Almost everyone up for Calgary. They do leave their two center backs back at around the midfield circle. And even Sean Melvin comes way out. Long shot there. Gets through the forest a little bit. Bouncing around. Calgary still trying to get it in. And just trying to get control now is Lane United. They do finally. Pantoja, but it's intercepted. Numbers.
We'll take
shot
that.
High.
That was fortunate for Lane United. There was two supporting players around the center back that ended up with that ball, which was Wheeldon. He had two options to play a player a little closer to the goal, but decided to go with the shot, which went sky over the bar.
Well, in the last maybe 2 minutes, all the game has tilted a little bit towards Calgary. See if Lane United can just get the ball back into the attacking third. They might be able to sustain it there, but for now, a little bit nervous for the boys in red. Christian Kata trying to chase that down. Will be a Calgary throw-in. And a substitution coming. It is a Calgary change.
Yeah, if you're Lane United head coach John Gallus, you like seeing Kata's enthusiasm going forward. He really wants that ball in behind, and I think it might all it will take is one, and I think he's focused enough and anxious enough to go and put that thing away and end this game. But we have yet to see that production from the midfield finding that through ball. There's been not as much link up today, at least in the second half compared to the first half between midfielders and backs. So still a crucial and critical part to this game if we want to see a good result for Lane United.
And Calgary still trying to get possession here. In fact, they do get the throw in after that. Well, they thought they did anyway, but the referee had actually announced differently, and it will be a Lane United throw in the 87th minute, and I think Gabriel's gone partly into coach mode here. Little tense?
No, just watching, stretching. Thinking about both situations here for what Calgary's mentality is, what their plan is here going into the last few minutes of this game. And then, I can tell you by looking at John, Lane United is definitely going to go for this. They're not going to sit back. They're going to push numbers forward. I do see something, though, being created here on the left side. If they get the ball left, it would be a good route to end this. Oof, another close one.
Well, meanwhile, it is Calgary, who the last 5 minutes have really had all of the attack, and Vito Paletto there nearly took a piece out of the ball kid behind the goal.
Yeah, but this left side, it's sort of some untapped space. It was there earlier in the game, and you saw some success with some of the players that occupied that space, but now play has gone to the other side where it seems to be a wall of white defenders and white Calgary players.
Will Seymour there trying to do something, and Mueller couldn't quite keep that in play. Throw in coming for Calgary. They throw it in. Bosch with the tap to Paletto. And now back to Bosch.
There we go with a good counterattack.
Here's a counter opportunity. Isma Fernández. Fernandez to Matias Binder. Binder slows it down a little bit. Now gets it to teammate on the wing there. Binder back and Pantoja.
Phillips needs this ball. Good, and Kata's inside.
Phillips will think about it. Now he plays it for Mueller, but too much on it. It's a sense of what it's like legs-wise as a player here, 88th minute of a hard-fought, tense game like this.
More than anything, it's your mentality that starts to go. Your decision-making starts to become a little bit more relaxed, fatigue sets in, so that's when you see teams take advantage of that and exploit those mistakes.
And both of these teams have guys that are very talented one-on-one, and that could come into play in the last moments here. Pantoa with it.
It's a great ball.
Long ball for Kata. Kata with Mueller. Kata gets it. Mueller couldn't get the shot off. But Casey Phillips gets to it. Phillips now, no one in the middle, and just the clearance out of play. Phillips will wait for it to go out, now collects it. 89th minute, Lane United, dangerous position. Pantoa tried to get it to the middle. Will Seymour is going to have to get that one and knocks it back for Stadler.
Keeping Pantoa high right here with Mueller would be a good move for Lane United. Keep numbers forward, keep in the middle of the field. Leave Phillips here in a 1v1.
Seymour again back for Stadler, and then Stadler played it all the way to Bersano, who got it right back to the number 21. Last minute of regular time. And then a little bit of stoppage time to be sure. Lane United trying to make it deadly.
Phillips back door again. If Phillips decides to push higher, he could come on to a second to the second ball here.
Fernandez almost got to that one. Binder gives chase and tackle error. Eventually the foul called. Fans don't like it. Will Seymour especially does not like it.
Smart foul though. Will slowed it down. He was, you know, Calgary were one touch away from threading that into a streaking forward that probably would have found himself going 1v1 against Bersano.
And there was a card given on that play. I'm not. It looked like it was probably given, in fact, to Will Seymour for the sort of spike after the play, and you understand the frustration, but when you're in a situation where falls down, but referee comes in with the whistle. But for Seymour there, that card might not have a big impact on the game so much, but when you have a finite number of yellow cards you can take in a season without coming up with a suspension due to accumulation, you'd like to limit the cards for stuff like that.
Mm-hmm. Sure, and there's your game. So Calgary happy probably with their 1 point. Lane United disappointed they didn't get all three. Good game overall though.
Yeah, and Mueller knocked that one out of the park after the whistle had gone. That will be the final score, and you would have hoped from a fan perspective to see some second half stoppage time. Really had virtually none of it, but what can you do? The referees get to make those decisions, and 1-1 is a lot better than 2-0, the scores that we'd seen the two other broadcasts that we'd done in PDL play. Lane United's goal, it came in the 26th minute from Timothy Mueller. And then just about 3 minutes later, Calgary was able to get on the board themselves. So a good 1-1 game. All the action scoring-wise came in the first half, but no shortage of entertainment in the second. You have a player of the game for us?
I like Pantoja a lot. I thought Pantoja was the creative piece that was lacking tremendously in the last few games, and he by himself solved a lot of the problems that Lane had experienced trying to attack, and he provided a link from the backs to the forwards and was a handful for the Calgary team to keep up with. Now I also think Mueller was probably at his best game, very consistent with his diagonal runs, his decisions to come to the ball, not run away from the ball and look for it over the top. We're good, but it's something to work with. I think John will go into the locker room not entirely angry with the result, but he did see some new looks from his team, which are sort of inspiring.
Certainly encouraging and very good for Lane United to get that first home goal of PDL play, get the point as well. I think all told, a satisfactory performance from the Reds tonight. One more time for Gabriel Hernandez. My name is Isaac Rosenthal. Thank you so much for listening and have a wonderful night.